66th Annual Emmy Awards. And now, your host, Seth Meyers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Seth Meyers, and welcome. Welcome to the Emmy Awards. This year, we're doing the Emmys on a Monday night in August, which, if I understand television, means the Emmys are about to get canceled. We're doing the show on Monday in part because MTV aired the Video Music Awards last night. That's right, MTV still has an award show for music videos, even though they no longer show music videos. That's like network TV holding an award show and giving all the trophies to cable and Netflix. That would be crazy. Why would they do that? NBC also decided to hold the Emmys a month earlier in August to avoid conflicting with Sunday Night Football, which is keeping with the actors' tradition of running away from jocks. Jokes are like nominees. They can't all be winners. This is the first Monday's Emmy since 1976, and let me see, TV is so much better now than it was then. This year, there are 6 nominees for Best Drama, ranging from Downton Abbey to Mad Men to Game of Thrones. So many different styles. In 1976, this is true, all 4 nominees were cop shows, including Police Story, Beretta, and Columbo. Basically, you voted for the policeman whose hat you liked the best. Of course, people don't remember the 1976 Emmys because they were held on a Monday. But it doesn't matter what night we're holding the Emmys because we had so many great shows this year. We had comedies that made you laugh and comedies that made you cry because they were dramas submitted as comedies. There has been some controversy over which categories certain shows were submitted in. For example, Orange is the New Black was submitted as a comedy rather than a drama. Give it up. True Detective was submitted as a drama instead of a miniseries. And Bachelor in Paradise was submitted. In fairness, it is getting hard to categorize TV shows because the writers working in television are doing more interesting and complex work than ever before. And I would like to take a moment to congratulate the writers in the room tonight, but their seats are too far away for them to hear me. Give it up. And I have to say, the Emmys are my favorite award show. Sure, the Golden Globes has alcohol, but everybody's always talking and moving around. Here, everyone sits silently in one place and just waits for the pills to kick in. Tonight, we are all crazy eyes. Speaking of the Globes, I'm actually lucky enough to be a nominee tonight because I was part of the team that wrote for Tina and Amy when they hosted that show. And when I got in touch with them and asked if they'd like to help me out with my monologue tonight, they both jumped at the chance to text back, "New phone, who dis?" This year, we saw the series finales of many popular shows, including Breaking Bad, Dexter, and How I Met Your Mother. And if you had asked me which of those shows would have the saddest ending, I would not have picked the one about the nice man telling a story to his children. That's right, kids. Jesse Pinkman lived, Dexter lived, but your mother didn't make it. Sleep tight. Shows like Game of Thrones, The Good Wife, and Fargo have the right idea. When your show starts getting some attention and critical acclaim, kill off all the main characters. Otherwise, before you know it, you're paying Sheldon $1 million an episode. You are worth every penny. Every penny. This will also be the final season for shows like Glee, 2 and a Half Men, and Sons of Anarchy, as well as almost every new show to premiere this fall. Congratulations to HBO. Give it up for HBO. They have 99 nominations tonight, the most of any network. Not to be outdone, NBC is also a network. HBO, I gotta say, HBO is like the kid you grew up with who ended up doing way better than you expected. 99 nominations. When I first met HBO, all he had was Grease 2 and Fraggle Rock. I wish I was nicer to him. You guys wanna watch Poltergeist? We watched it yesterday, HBO. How many times do you think people wanna watch the same movie?
One day I'm gonna make a show about dragons.
Okay, buddy, best of luck. Best of luck with that, HBO. I'm sure you will. Streaming made a huge impact this year with Netflix getting nominated for 31 Emmys. And no one is happier to see streaming services take nominations away from cable than network television. Not very nice when someone younger comes along, is it, cable? Cable is looking at Netflix the way Justin Bieber looks at One Direction, through a cloud of marijuana smoke. There are so many different ways to consume TV. People don't necessarily watch shows when they air anymore. The most DVR'd show of the past season was Blacklist. Game of Thrones was the most pirated show, and Duck Dynasty was the most VCR taped. Congratulations to Game of Thrones, nominated for 19 Emmys, including Best Drama, Best Supporting Actor, and Worst Job Security. If you're an actor on Game of Thrones, I imagine you wait for next week's script the way most people wait for biopsy results. I think you better sit down. Your character's been invited to a wedding. But before we get too far along in the night, I just want to remind everyone, even if you don't win this evening, your agent still wants you to know that you're crushing it right now. Just killing it, buddy. So great. In conclusion, I'm so happy to be here tonight because I love television, and not just the high-end cinematic stuff we're honoring tonight, but the low-rent cable series I stream onto a 4-inch screen while I'm on the bike at Equinox. That's what I love about television. She doesn't play hard to get. She doesn't demand your full attention. Television has always been the booty call friend of entertainment. You don't ever have to ask TV, you up. TV's always up. She'll happily entertain you while you cook dinner or wrap your Christmas presents. She's not like that high-maintenance diva movies who expects you to put on pants and drive all the way over to her house and buy $40 worth of soda. So thanks anyways, movies, but I'm sticking with TV. Let's give it up for TV, everyone. We're gonna have a great night. We're gonna have a great night. Our first presenter asked to write her own introduction, so please welcome my beautiful, amazing, and talented friend, Beyoncé.
Honored to announce the first award of the evening, Best On-Screen Orgasm in a Civil War Reenactment. I meant Best Supporting Actor in a Comedy. The nominees are Fred Armisen, Portlandia. Andre Brower, Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Ty Burrell, Modern Family. Adam Driver, Girls. Jesse Tyler Ferguson, Modern Family. Tony Hale, Veep. And the Emmy goes to Ty Burrell, Modern Family.
The second Emmy win and fifth consecutive nomination for Ty Burrell, who was born in Grants Pass in Southern Oregon.
Hi. I had a speech, but apparently the kids in the cast of Modern Family wrote one for me too, so they handed it to me when I got here, so I think I'll read that instead. Thank you so much to the Academy for this Emmy, and also to Fox and ABC for my job. I should probably thank my wife because she's super pretty. I also want to thank my two children that I bring to set sometimes. They're definitely cute. They're just not, I can support my whole family cute. All right. Speaking of children, I want to thank the kids on Modern Family for their incredible performances week in and week out. I would give them a big hug right now, but it would take me 20 minutes to get to their seats. The adults in the cast deserve our nominations, even though the kids have never been nominated, because we do something totally different than they do. All right. We complain. JK, JK. No, seriously, the adults really do deserve the Emmys in this cast because we have more material, we work harder, and we're always so prepared. Sometimes it's hard to tell from the written word, so to be clear, that was sarcasm. Anyways, I'm so grateful for this award, and I can't wait to give it to Nolan Guth. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Our next presenters are Zooey Deschanel from The New Girl and Allison Williams from Girls. One is known for a show where she has bangs. One is known for a show where everyone bangs. Please welcome Zooey Deschanel and the new Peter Pan, Allison Williams.
Good looking.
In shape.
Sociable.
Comfortable in formal wear.
These are all words that have been used to describe comedy writers.
By comedy writers.
The nominees for Outstanding Writing in a Comedy Series are...
Episodes. Episode 305, written by David Crane and Jeffrey Clare. Louie, So Did the Fat Lady, written by Louis C.K. Orange is the New Black, I Wasn't Ready, written by Liz Friedman and Jenji Cohan. Veep, Special Relationship, written by Simon Blackwell, Tony Roach, and Armando Iannucci. Silicon Valley, Optimal Tip-to-Tip Efficiency, written by Alec Berg.
And the Emmy goes to... Louis C.K.!
This is the 6th Emmy win and 30th nomination for Louis C.K.
Thank you, that's very nice. I appreciate that. Thank you. I want to thank Sarah Baker, who played the main role in the episode. It was great. And Bobby Kelly also, he was great in it. And Blair Briard, who produces my show, and FX, Pamela Adlon, and Stephen Wright, and Vernon Chapman, who helped me with the writing. And I'd like to thank Ron Lynch, who gave me my first shot as a comedian, and Conan O'Brien, who gave me my first job on television. That goes way back. That's all. I really appreciate this very much. Thank you.
This next presenter is one half of the comedy team Guillermo and Kimmel. Please welcome Kimmel.
Hey, I have a question. I don't mean to ruin anything, but is that Matthew McConaughey right here? That is? You got so fat since the Oscars, I almost didn't recognize you. Why is Matthew McConaughey nominated for a television award? Matthew McConaughey doesn't even own a television. I happen to know for a fact that he traded his television for a conch shell full of weed. I mean, don't get me wrong, you were...
Woody.
No, that wasn't Woody. Woody's a television guy. You were great in True Detective. You may well be the best actor, but you just won the Oscar like 5 months ago. It's no offense, but how many of those speeches of yours are we supposed to sit through? I mean, all right, already. Should we give you the BET Award for Best Male Hip-Hop Artist, too, while we're at it? You beautiful son of a bitch. Look at that face. That's not a television face. That's a movie star face right there. That is... Where's Ricky? Ricky... Now, Rick, that is a television face. Okay? That's what... Not even really a television face, it's a Netflix face. All right, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna give out an award, not to you, to someone else. And while I'm doing it, I want you and your brother Rooster and to pack up your bongos and your patchouli oil and your bong shaped like Willie Nelson's boot and go to Burning Man or something, because you don't belong here. And take Julia Roberts with you while you're at it. The nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Comedy Series are... Kate McKinnon, Saturday Night Live. Julie Bowen, Modern Family. Anna Chlumsky, Veep. Kate Mulgrew, Orange is the New Black. Mayim Bialik, The Big Bang Theory. Allison Janney, Mom. Shout out to our friend Tracy Morgan. We'll see you next year, Tracy. And the Emmy goes to Allison Janney, Mom.
This is the sixth career Emmy and second Emmy win this year for Allison Janney.
So much. Thank you to the members of the Television Academy. Listen, I play a mom on Mom. I play a grandmother, and as of last season, I play a great grandmother. And I'm just crossing my fingers. This season, I'll be incontinent. That's my. I want to thank Chuck Lorre. It's an honor and privilege to work for you. A genius man. I really. All the writers on Mom, Eddie Gordetsky, Gemma Baker, and Nick Bakay, and all my friends at CBS, Les Moonves, and Nina Tassler, and at Warner Brothers, Peter Roth, the best hugger on the planet. If anyone's ever worked, you know that. Anna Faris, I share this with you. She is the sister I never had. She's the daughter I never had. She's everything I never had. She is beautiful and sublime, as my entire cast is. I thank them and the whole crew and all the people that work behind the scenes to make what I choose look like it was my idea. Henze and Sievert and Rice and Sanfilippo. This is an amazing honor. Thank you. Number six, let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hayden Panettiere.
On August 16th, the Creative Arts Emmys recognized this year's nominees for Guest Actor and Actress in a Comedy Series. The nominees were Steve Buscemi, Portlandia. Louis C.K., Saturday Night Live. Gary Cole, Veep. Jimmy Fallon, Saturday Night Live. Nathan Lane, Modern Family. Bob Newhart, The Big Bang Theory. Uzo Aduba, Orange is the New Black. Laverne Cox, Orange is the New Black. Joan Cusack, Shameless. Tina Fey, Saturday Night Live. Natasha Lyonne, Orange is the New Black. Melissa McCarthy, Saturday Night Live. The winners were Jimmy Fallon and Uzo Aduba. And I am thrilled that Uzo will join me now to present the next award. Uzo, come on out of here, girl.
I'm honored to present the award for Outstanding Directing for a Comedy Series.
And the nominees are Paris Barclay, Glee 100.
The best direction that Paris ever gave me was good. Now this time, do it better.
Louis C.K., Louis Elevator Part 6.
The best direction Louis C.K. ever gave me was in the episode where my character gets caught smoking pot. He taught me how to hold a joint.
Ian B. McDonald, episodes, episode 309.
The best piece of direction that Ian B. McDonald gave us was...
Jodie Foster, Orange is the New Black, lesbian request denied.
The best part about working with Jodie Foster is there's no pressure because you know you'll just never be as good as she is.
Mike Judge, Silicon Valley, minimum viable product.
The best direction that Mike Judge ever gave me was the same he gives to every actor for every line and every scene. Go to that inner place in your mind where ideas begin. Stay there. Lock the door. And learn your lines.
Gail Mancuso, Modern Family, Las Vegas.
The best direction that Gail Mancuso ever gave us was probably just to listen to your fellow actor.
Yes, absolutely.
Because that's where you
listening
where
and
you
also
more,
to connecting with a
you're person. You're less self-conscious.
When you're in a scene with them and you're making eye contact, you're using your whole body, and you are
you're not thinking about freeing yourself up, but more generous.
And that's Gail.
Amazing. And the Emmy goes to
Gail Mancuso, Modern Family.
This is the second consecutive Emmy win and third nomination for Gail Mancuso. She grew up in suburban Cook County, Illinois, and began her career as an usher on television talk shows.
Thank you so much to the Television Academy. I really, really appreciate that. And congratulations to all my fellow nominees. It was an amazing, healthy category this year. I feel like I'm gonna lose it. I feel like I wanna look at my cast and I love them so much. And if you don't mind, Matthew McConaughey, I'm just gonna kind of make eye contact with you right now. It's much better, thank you. So Matthew, I'm gonna talk about how great my producers are over there. Jeff Morton, Steve Levitan, Chris Lloyd. I can't look at them because I'll cry. They produce a wonderful show, and which was written by, if the cameraman could get out of my way a little bit, that'd be great. Thank you, I'm just trying to direct this. Right there, baby, right there. Thank you for staying with me. Thank you. The Las Vegas episode was written by amazing writers, Chris Lloyd, who's also our showrunner, Bill Rubel, Brad Walsh, and Paul Corrigan. I got it! Ugh! And acted by our fabulous talent. I'm going to shift my gaze just for a second to my cast over there, which I love. And you guys trusted me this whole time during the Las Vegas Farce episode, and I thank you for that. Who else? Okay, I'm going to now take my eyes off of you because I want to look at my husband, Brian, who I love so much, and I never get tired of looking at you. I love you, honey. Thank you so much. But what's really significant about this is the 66th Emmy Awards. 66 years ago, this week, my parents, Jerry and Vi Mancuso, got married, produced three kids, Gary, Greg, and Gail, and I just want to thank them for giving me a great life. Thank you.
Everyone, this is my good friend, Billy Eichner from Billy on the Street.
Hello, everyone. Hi.
It goes without saying that everyone here in Los Angeles has Emmy fever, but last week, Billy and I took to the streets of New York City to see how excited people are on the other side of the country. Let's take a look.
We're about to hit the streets of New York to play a special Emmy edition of a game from my show called For a Dollar, where people can win money if they agree with me about pop culture. Are you ready, Seth?
I am.
Let's go. Miss, it's television's biggest night. Can you feel it?
No.
Oh, miss, for a dollar, true or false, Maggie Smith doesn't give a about these awards.
True.
Yes, correct, thank you.
Sir,
For a dollar, who's your favorite talk show host? Jimmy Fallon, Jimmy Kimmel, or Seth Meyers?
Jimmy Fallon.
Yes, thank you. There you go. Correct. Miss, the Emmy Awards are here.
Terrific.
Are you excited?
Very much so.
This is Seth Meyers. He's hosting.
Oh, for God's sakes.
Oh, for God's sakes!
Sir, good news. Yahoo picked up Community, and Hotmail just picked up 12 new episodes of Judging Amy. Wow.
Hey, man,
no, I'm talking about Judging Amy!
Sir, for a dollar, name this year's Emmy host.
I couldn't.
No idea?
Not at all.
I'll give you a hint. He's standing right next to me.
Oh, okay. McFarlane. No.
No, not Seth McFarlane! How dare you!
Miss, we're taking donations for the cast of The Big Bang Theory. Please give,
anything
sir.
Anything you can do.
Big Bang Theory?
Yes,
Jim Parsons. Yes, please.
They work very hard. Thank
yes,
so
they're
much.
So talented. Oh, my
thank
God.
So
oh, God. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Johnny Galecki. Thanks you. Sir, The Mindy Project was snubbed.
Oh.
Mindy Kaling for the Emmys.
I can't believe that.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
We can't believe it either.
They made her get up at 5 a.m. to announce the nominations and then even nominate her.
What the hell?
Exactly. It's unfair.
It is.
You know who was sleeping soundly? Perennial nominee Julie Bowen. Miss, for a dollar, what is this?
A trophy?
What kind of trophy? It's the biggest award in our industry.
The Academy?
What do they call this one?
Goldblum?
What?
Goldblum?
What did you say, gold bull? Excuse me?
I don't...
What? I don't even know what word she's saying.
It is the...
Anniversary?
No! Damn it!
Miss Tatiana Maslany was snubbed.
Oh, really?
She was snubbed.
Shame.
Oh, sir, Tatiana Maslany was snubbed.
Who cares?
Oh, Elizabeth Moss was snubbed. She was snubbed. Miss The Good Wife was snubbed. Oh, The Good Wife was snubbed! Dinklage versus Patinkin! Dinklage versus Patinkin! Miss, you're a lesbian. You're watching Orange is the New Black?
I do, but I'm not a lesbian.
Oh, okay, sorry. Miss, for a dollar, name one Emmy nominee this year.
Just one.
Just one. What is it? No, he's not nominated!
I'm not nominated.
No, name one, Miss! Name one!
You can do this.
You can do it!
Any show.
Walking backwards. Name one. Name one.
Jimmy Fallon.
Yes, you go! Take it!
Emmy winners Bryan Cranston and Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
We are here to present the award for lead actor in a comedy.
Yeah.
In comedy.
Hold on, Clark Gable. Hang on. Bryan, seriously, I just have to say something. You are honestly so unbelievably fantastic in Breaking Bad.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right. No.
Thank you. Comedy.
No, really. Listen, because your performance is just so authentic. It's so raw. It's just, it's riveting in every way. Wow. And we were binge-watching it. And I have to tell you, you look so much like the actor in Seinfeld who played the dentist that I dated as Elaine, you know, and who converted to Judaism for the jokes.
Tim Watley.
Tim Watley, yes, good for you, that's right, good.
That was me,
The nominees are Louis C.K., Louis. Don Cheadle, House of Lies. Ricky Gervais, Derek. Matt LeBlanc, Episodes. William H. Macy, Shameless. Jim Parsons, The Big Bang Theory.
We actually had a kissing scene together. And the... The Emmy goes to Jim Parsons, The Big Bang.
This is the fourth career Emmy and seventh nomination for Jim Parsons.
Um,
Wow. Oh, my God. I really don't believe this. I want to start off by saying something to the other nominees in the category. To say that I watch your work and I feel inspired is a bit of an understatement. I watch you work, and all of you, and I see you people doing things that I couldn't do. I see people doing things that I wouldn't do. I see people doing things, in all seriousness, that are so divergent and all over the place, and all of us doing such different things that I do pray to do one day. I really do. But that's the landscape we live in, and this is all a long way of saying there's no accounting for taste, and that's through a lot of good fortune I stand up here tonight. Thank you, Warner Brothers and CBS. Thank you, Chuck Lorre. Thank you, Steve Molaro and Bill Prady. I want to thank somebody that I've never thanked before, largely because he passed away shortly before this craziness started, even though I think he was able to see it in his own way. But it's my father, Mickey Parsons. He encouraged me to be an actor. He never discouraged me to be an actor. And in a career that hinges so much on confidence a lot of the time, that was a really great gift. So thank him, and thank all of you. I mean that. Thank you. Good night.
Here we go. Stand by. Ready to break it for two full. Bring it full. Music out, please. Seven. Music out. Take seven. Cue them.
Our next presenter usually introduces me every night, which means it must be backwards day. So all agents, give 10% of your salary to your clients, and please welcome my good friend, Jimmy Fallon.
As actors, performers, artists, we inspire each other. We push each other to be the best we can be, even in competition. We're not tearing each other down, we're lifting each other up. Look around the room. None of us would be where we are today without our colleagues and fellow nominees. And despite any differences we may have, we must always strive to remember that within each and every one of us, whether we sing or dance or make people laugh or make them cry, there's one common truth that binds us all together. None of us will ever make as much money as Kim Kardashian did for her iPhone game. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Lead Actress in a Comedy Series. Lena Dunham, Girls. Edie Falco, Nurse Jackie. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, Veep. Melissa McCarthy, Mike and Molly. Amy Pueblo, Parks and Recreation. Taylor Schilling, Orange is the New Black. And the Emmy goes to Julia Louis-Dreyfus for Veep.
This is the third consecutive Emmy win for Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Over her career, she's won 5 Emmys and had 18 nominations. Previous wins have been for Seinfeld, The New Adventures of Old Christine, and Veep.
Yeah, he was on Seinfeld, yeah. Okay, I would love to thank HBO, because honestly, I've worked in a lot of places in this town, and it's absolutely my favorite place I've ever worked. I'd like to thank, I'd like to thank everybody on our show, obviously, our intrepid, hilarious writers. Huge shout out to them, of course, and specifically to Tony Roach, Simon Blackwell, and Chris Addison, our director, without whom we couldn't do this program. And our great cast, whom I adore, and all of our producers and all of our crew who work so hard, and of course our superb leader, Armando Iannucci. I mean, come on, forget about it. But I have to say, this show is very dense, as you might notice, and it's a huge labor of love. And every labor of love takes a lot of labor. So, a lot of labor, this one particularly. So I really want to thank everybody on the show for having such extraordinary grace under pressure and for having so much fun. Thank you, and thank you.
When Fox was casting the shows The Mindy Project and Mulaney, these two actors were locks to be the leads. Please welcome Mindy Kaling and John Mulaney.
We are here to present the Emmy for Outstanding Reality Competition Program.
Reality shows aren't just the thing you insist your husband watch with you before you have sex with him.
They're also the thing putting hundreds of writers out of work. Just kidding, we all know reality shows are written.
The nominees are...
The Amazing Race.
Dancing with the Stars.
Project Runway.
So You Think You Can Dance.
Top Chef.
The Voice.
And the Emmy goes to... The Amazing Race.
The Amazing Race has won 6 Emmy nominations this year. This is the show's 10th win in this category. Accepting the Emmy on behalf of the team is Bertram Van Munster.
I can assure you we didn't expect this at all, really. So I want to thank the Academy, CBS, Les Moonves, Nina Tesler, Chris Costello over there, and all the hundreds and hundreds of people that work so hard on the show around the world. The world is not a bad place, actually. You can go safely to a lot of places, contrary to what they make you believe. So thank you all so very, very much.
Began her career in television and received her first Emmy nomination in 1999. As an Oscar-winning film actress, she returns to television tonight with a second Emmy nomination for her role in The Normal Heart.
You want my data? You want my ideas? You want my papers? Take them! Just do something with them!
Supporting actress in a miniseries or movie when we return. NBC...
You know, a lot of people have questions about the Emmys and how it all works, so we thought we'd take some time tonight to see if I can help answer any you might have. Yes, you, sir.
Thanks for taking my question. I wanted to know if the show will be televised, and if so, when will it be on the air?
It is televised. It's airing right now.
Oh, so I'm on TV?
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes, I got one down there.
I have a parking question.
Okay.
I was running just a little bit late, so I couldn't really get into that garage, so I just kind of ramped it up there on the curb, and I'm wondering, will I be towed?
I think you will be towed, yes.
Okay, and then that's even including if I left a note on the dash that said, at the Emmys, don't tow me.
I still think you'll be towed, yeah.
Well, Edie Falco said that if I left a note, I would definitely and for sure not get towed. Oh, Edie. This is coming out of nowhere.
Yes, over there?
Can I use the bathroom?
Yeah, you don't have to ask me, you know, just go.
Yeah, but don't I need a key?
Oh, yeah. Who has the bathroom key?
Sorry, Seth, I forgot I had it.
All right, guys. We need to remember we only have the one key, all right? Yes, in the front over there.
Hi. I see that Maggie Smith isn't here tonight.
Yeah.
So, if she wins the Emmy, can I have it?
No.
Why?
Someone else already called it.
Who?
Yes, over there.
I'm having a really great time. I'm wondering, maybe this is something they'll consider doing every year?
This is annual.
Well, I don't know about that, but I say we should do this every year. Every year! Every year! Every year!
All right,
year.
That's enough!
Every
that's enough!
Year.
Settle
every
down!
Year.
It's time for a genre change.
Please welcome Allison Janney and Octavia Spencer.
I know what you're thinking, that we're here to announce a sequel to The Help, and you'd be right.
Not quite yet, Allison.
No?
No.
Okay.
Instead, we're here to announce the nominees for Outstanding Writing in a Miniseries, Movie, or Dramatic Special. They are...
American Horror Story Coven, Bitchcraft, written by Ryan Murphy and Brad Falchuk. Tremé, To Miss New Orleans, written by David Simon and Eric Overmeyer. The Normal Heart, written by Larry Kramer. Sherlock, His Last Vow, written by Stephen Moffat. Fargo, The Crocodile's Dilemma, written by Noah Hawley. Luther, written by Neil Cross.
And the Emmy goes to Stephen Moffat, Sherlock, His Last Vow.
Born in Paisley, Scotland, this is the first Emmy win and fifth nomination for Stephen Moffat. He's a lifelong fan of Doctor Who and has written for the revived version.
Thank you for PBS Masterpiece for suggesting that I prepare something in advance in the event I won, and apologies to the same for not doing that. To the BBC, the greatest broadcaster in the world, and to Hartswood Films, who, actually make it. A huge thanks to my brilliant, sexy producer, whom I also married. And although I would marry him, I haven't married Mark Gatiss. He should be up here because every word of Sherlock is down to him as well, and I apologize for him not being up here at the same time. Thank you so much. This is utterly thrilling.
And now, here are the nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Miniseries or Movie. Angela Bassett, American Horror Story, Coven. Kathy Bates, American Horror Story, Coven. Ellen Burstyn, Flowers in the Attic. Frances Conroy, American Horror Story, Coven. Julia Roberts, The Normal Heart. Allison Tolman, Fargo.
And the Emmy goes to Kathy Bates, American Horror Story Coven.
Raised in Memphis, Tennessee, this is the second Emmy win and 11th nomination for Kathy Bates. She won her first Emmy as a guest actress on 2.5 Men.
Okay, well,
Well, I was sure I wasn't going to win. I'm serious, because the first place I went when I got here was the green room, and there were the guys in there with the little silver suitcase, and they had it open. It was like they were going through the winners and losers. And so they caught my eye when I walked in, and they both kind of tilted their heads in that sort of social worker, I'm sorry, way. And then I came in tonight, and I was way over there, and I thought, yeah, that's right, I'm not going to win. Anyway, I have to thank everybody who had anything to do with our show. Last season was awesome. This season's going to be great. And I want to thank especially our crew, our writers, but our crew in New Orleans who worked grueling hours, to bring this wonderful show to life. This is for them. Thank you all so very much. Thank you.
I feel so bad for our next presenter because he recently found out he's being demoted from cable to network TV. Please welcome Stephen Colbert.
Good evening. When the president of television called me, asking me if I would be here tonight, I said, yes, sir. I would be honored to present the award for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a miniseries or movie. But to be honest, I'm also a little miffed because somehow the Academy has once again overlooked who I believe is the greatest supporting actor of his generation, and he's standing on stage before you right now. I'm talking, of course, about my imaginary friend, Roscoe. You were robbed, buddy. For 9 years, this man has stood by my side since day one of my show, never making a peep, never hogging the spotlight, letting me shine. No, they need to hear this. This, what? No, I'm not embarrassing you. Is it embarrassing to tell the world how I feel about my best? Nay, my only friend? Oh, walk away. Walk away, that'll solve it, that solves everything. Just walk away like all my imaginary friends have. Oh, Roscoe. Oh, Roscoe. Damn it, he has the limo driver's number. Anyway, the nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a miniseries or movie are
Martin Freeman, Sherlock, His Last Vow. Colin Hanks, Fargo. Joe Mantello, The Normal Heart. Matt Bomer, The Normal Heart. Alfred Molina, The Normal Heart. Jim Parsons, The Normal Heart.
And the Emmy goes to Martin Freeman, Sherlock, His Last Vow. Martin couldn't be here tonight, so I accept this award on my behalf. Thank you.
Please welcome Scott Bakula and Kate Walsh.
All right, here we are. Don't know where that teleprompter is. Hey, here we are. And here are the nominees for Outstanding Directing for a Miniseries, Movie, or Dramatic Special.
Adam Bernstein, Fargo, The Crocodile's Dilemma.
The best direction that Adam ever gave me was to remember that the way my character, Molly, gets things done is more with honey than with vinegar.
Alfonso Gomez-Rejon, American Horror Story Coven, Bitchcraft.
Alfonso is a great director because he really listens. He's listening for the truth and the honesty of the scene, and I just don't think you can ask for anything more than that in a director.
Stephen Frears, Muhammad Ali's Greatest Fight.
One piece of direction I remember vividly, I was, as Harry Blackmun, one of the justices, to stand up to Chief Justice Burger for the first time, and he came over and he said, "Do you think you've ever stood up to any male authority figures in your life before this?"
Nick Herron, Sherlock, His Last Bow.
Sherlock getting shot was a fantastic thing to film. It's one of those great combinations of writing, brilliant directorial ideas from Nick, and phenomenal expertise in the art department. Remarkable. Really, really cool.
Ryan Murphy, The Normal Heart.
Ryan's level of preparation on this project was so comprehensive that the minute you walked on the set, you were in the world of the film, and you immediately knew to trust him with everything.
Colin Buxey, Fargo, Buridan's Ass.
I was fortunate in that the best direction I got from Colin was cut, print, we're moving on, that was perfect. Now go get warm somewhere.
And the Emmy goes to Colin Buxey, Fargo.
A native of England, this is the first Emmy win and nomination for Colin Buxey.
This is such a surprise. I'm so glad I got back from the loo in time. Noah Hawley, Warren Littlefield, thank you for asking me to do this show. Thank you to a fantastic cast, to my fellow technicians in Calgary who froze in sub-zero temperatures along with me, and my thanks to the Academy. This is a real honor. Thank you.
Next, Matthew McConaughey and Woody Harrelson present together. Also, Halle Berry, Jim Parsons, and lead actress in a miniseries or movie.
Who's the baddest witch in town?
When the Emmys continue on NBC.
Hey there, you guys know Amy.
Hello, everyone.
So, I brought Amy out here because we're about to introduce Matthew McConaughey and Woody Harrelson, our next two presenters, and that's a big deal to
introduce
them.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of play tonight.
Yeah, and so because of that, we wanted to make sure we gave them the best possible introduction, so we wrote a bunch of them, and if you don't mind, we're just going to read through them now.
Yeah.
You want to start, Amy?
See which one works the best. Okay, let's see. Oh, this one's good. Please welcome two men who also have no idea what happened at the end of True Detective.
Yeah, that's not bad.
No, that's not bad.
Maybe not, maybe not.
Okay.
One is named after a disciple of Jesus, the other is named after a boner. Probably not, we can't do that, right?
We can try.
We could try it, but I think they deserve better.
They do. Please welcome two gentlemen whose names are also menu items at most marijuana dispensaries.
Oh, I like that.
I like that one too, and I'm going to save that one for later.
For me, watching these next two presenters in True Detective was like making love. I didn't understand what was going on, but boy did I like it.
Now, and don't say making love, it's gross.
Well, what do you want me to call it?
I don't want you to call it anything.
Oh, right, okay.
Okay, what else you got?
Please welcome the past version of their future selves. That's way too confusing. What does that even mean?
I get it, but it's over your head.
Okay, got it.
Please welcome two gentlemen who seem like they'd be chatty in the sack.
Oh, that sounds accurate.
That does.
That sounds accurate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. Maybe not quite right, but
I got it. Seth, here's the one.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the only actors in Hollywood not rumored to be starring in season two of True Detective,
Matthew McConaughey and Woody Harrelson.
All right, all right, all right. Come on back to the Airstream after I make the best margarita this side of the Arroyo Grande.
I have said that. Let me share with you a little bit of worldly Woody wisdom, one of them, all right? So it's late last year. I had a little problem come up in my life, I had a conflict, something I had to deal with that I didn't want to deal with, but it was hard to deal with, and I had to. So I go to my friend Woody, thoughtful man and friend. I said, Woody, you know, you always seem to keep it pretty cool. What do you do when you got a problem or a conflict that comes up in your life? Being my good friend, he thinks about it for a minute. He lowers his head for about 15 or 20 seconds, And he looks back up to me and looks right in my eyes, deep into my soul, and he says, I just forget about it.
That's true. It's incredible how you do that.
It works. It really does work. I want to offer that to all of you. So you won an Oscar, Sexiest Man Alive, and now you want the Emmy, too. You think that might be a little bit greedy?
I think that you should have gratitude for what you have and not envy what I do. Best legs in the business, by the way.
Well, guy. I'm grateful you had all the plagiarized lines. Yeah.
Is that too much of an inside joke?
That was a little too inside.
All right, let's go to the nominees here for Outstanding Lead Actor in a miniseries or a movie.
Benedict Cumberbatch, Sherlock, His Last Vow. Idris Elba, Luther. Chiwetel Ejiofor, Dancing on the Edge. Martin Freeman, Fargo. Billy Bob Thornton, Fargo. Mark Ruffalo, The Normal Heart.
Yes, sir, you do.
Okay.
Right here, Wood.
And the Emmy goes to Benedict Cumberbatch.
And Benedict is not here tonight, so we're going to accept the award on his behalf.
As if he'll ever get it.
What's your favorite TV moment? Tweet along with NBC on Twitter.
This is Criminal Law 100. Or as I prefer to call it,
how to get away with murder.
We just have to get creative.
I want to be her.
I don't kiss and tell.
Either we all agree, or we stop right now.
Everybody wants to.
How to Get Away with Murder. Class starts Thursdays this fall on CTV.
Life lessons with Ziploc. The back-to-school supply list. It's never meant to be questioned. Even when it includes something odd. Like 150 cat's eye marbles. If this bag breaks, a great start to the school year could quickly slip away. That's not happening. Not with Ziploc. School needs Ziploc because life needs Ziploc.
SC Johnson. A family company.
I want that. Tablets in all shapes and sizes. With Bluetooth headphones and wireless speakers.
Get the back-to-school tech you want, like the Samsung Galaxy S5 Superphone. The source, I want that.
Watch. Nothing can stop Crizal lenses from giving you the clearest vision possible. Neither water, nor scratches, nor dust, nor smudges, nor glare. With an eye sun protection factor of 25, Crizal lenses protect your eyes 25 times more from the damaging UV rays of the sun. Crizal lenses. Live life in the clear. Ask for them at your eye care professional.
Hungry. Can I have some fruits and veggies, please? Veggies again. Do I have food?
In reality, we know it can be a challenge to get your kids to eat all the fruits and veggies they need. Good thing there's Mott's Fruit Stations Plus Veggies. Each cup has one serving of fruit and veggies, but don't tell them that. Undercover veggies, outrageous fruit taste. Also available in a convenient on-the-go pouch. Snack time struggles? Mott's Fruit Stations has a snack for that.
These aren't just tickets to some skinny jean boy band. These are the doors to paradise. And you are no longer ordinary parents. You are superheroes. How do we know? Because every year, we've thrilled card members with millions of the hottest tickets in town. We even arrange for a select few to meet their idols. Tears of joy and pounding hearts. Just part of the rock and roll service we deliver daily. American Express. Realize the potential.
Welcome to Clearwater Marine Aquarium.
Winter has been such an inspiration for me.
She's not doing well. Winter needs to be paired with another female, and soon.
Marine fisheries just picked up a stranding.
It's a female.
Hello, Hope.
What is wrong with that bird?
Where do I start?
We don't know if dolphins feel friendship. It feels like they do, and that's not a bad thing.
Dolphin Tale 2. Advance tickets on sale August 29th.
Closed captioning brought to you by Ariana Grande's new album, My Everything, available now.
And now, two attractive people who spend a lot of their time looking upset on television, Liev Schreiber and Kerry Washington.
They come from comedy and drama, from England and America, from different generations and backgrounds.
But what they have in common is their extraordinary talent. They are the nominees for Outstanding Lead Actress in a Miniseries or Movie.
Kristen Wiig, The Spoils of Babylon. Cicely Tyson, The Trip to Bountiful. Helena Bonham Carter, Burton and Taylor. Minnie Driver, Return to Zero. Jessica Lange, American Horror Story, Coven. Sarah Paulson, American Horror Story, Coven.
And the Emmy goes to Jessica Lange, American Horror Story, Coven.
This is the third Emmy win and sixth nomination for Jessica Lange.
Surprised at this, but very grateful. Thank you to the Academy, and special thanks to everybody who is is part of my life on this show. Starting with, as Kathy said, one of the greatest crews that work tirelessly. To our amazing set of directors. Our incredible writers and a cast that is just a dream come true, beginning to end. And of course, to Brad and to my darling Ryan, who makes this all possible. I don't know what to say. I truly am so surprised. Thank you very much.
I'm joined now by my good friend, Andy Samberg.
Thank you. Thank you, Seth.
And just let me be the first to say that it's an honor to be co-hosting the Emmys evening. No, we're not co-hosting. We're not? No.
Hey, I thought I came out kind of late.
Yeah.
How's it going so far? You look buff.
Okay. Andy and I love music and we love television, and nowhere do those two combine better than in a show's theme song.
And while themes today are better than ever, we miss the day where they had accompanying lyrics that explained the show's plot. Example, it's the story.
They get it.
Of a lovely lady.
You don't have to do this.
Who was bringing up three very lovely girls. Everyone!
No, not everyone.
Yeah, not everyone, guys. Come on, show some respect. Seth's in charge.
Okay, so tonight we thought we would take it upon ourselves to revamp some modern theme songs.
Helping us do the honors, please welcome a man whose new album just debuted at number one on the Billboard charts, my personal hero, Weird Al Yankovic.
Madmen, madmen, watch these admen do their thinking while they're stinking drunk.
John Hamm's never won an Emmy. Oh, who cares? He's still John freaking Hamm.
Madness. Her lip is quivering. It's not because she's cold, it's because she just loves the president. Remember this guy? He was in Ghost,
Scandal,
Homeland, standing in a maze, making out with terrorists, beautiful woman, ugly crying. And Nigel Montoya grew a beard. Homeland!
Hey, hey. Hey, hey.
It's my family.
Hey, hey.
My favorite old dude.
Hey, hey.
Couple of gay guys.
Hey, hey.
That's why it's modern family. Here come dragons galore and some boo. Okay, to be fair, there's way more booze. If you miss a big scene, watch it back.
Watch it over, watch it over, watch it over.
Hope you paid attention to the map.
You can pause that, you can pause that, you can pause that.
Don't get too attached to a certain guy.
In the tradition of novelists like Charles Dickens.
Mother! Mother! I think I've been poisoned!
Yeah, not now, Geoffrey, not now.
Oh, Mother! Why don't you love me like you love Uncle Jamie?
I said not now.
Mother!
In the tradition of novelists like Charles Dickens, who originally published their masterworks one chapter at a time, these chronicles unfolded over the season and weekly installments that kept us longing for the next one. The nominees for Outstanding Miniseries are American Horror Story Coven, Bonnie and Clyde, Fargo, Luther, Tremé, The White Queen. And the Emmy goes to Fargo.
Fargo received 18 Emmy nominations this year. Accepting the Emmy on behalf of the team is Noah Hawley.
Okay, this is a true story.
The first time I talked to Joel and Ethan Coen was when they called me after they read the script, and I had a baby strapped to me. I mean, my baby, not a random baby. And they said, look, we hate imitation, but it was eerie reading this because it felt like you were channeling us. So who else can I thank but Joel and Ethan Coen, who, of course, don't watch the Emmys. But they let me pretend, if only for 5 minutes, that I was one of the greatest filmmakers alive, and I thank them for that. I want to thank John Landgraf and everyone at FX. I want to thank everyone at MGM, my amazing cast, Billy and Martin and Allison and Colin and everyone. I want to thank my amazing producers, my crew. Let's do it again. What do you say?
Yes, please.
To cable and streaming, something you can only get on network television, please enjoy a whole bunch of commercials. We'll be right back.
Go, music, stand by. Let's stand by the pace of music and stop the music. Ready, eight, take eight, and cue Seth, six.
Please
take.
Welcome the only person from ER to ever amount to anything, Juliana Margulies.
Here are the nominees for Outstanding Television Movie.
Killing Kennedy. Muhammad Ali's Greatest Fight. The Normal Heart. Sherlock, His Last Bow. The Trip to Bountiful.
And the Emmy goes to The Normal Heart.
The Normal Heart received 16 nominations this year. Accepting the Emmy on behalf of the team is Ryan Murphy.
Thank you to the Academy. Thank you to HBO, particularly Michael Lombardo and Richard Plepler, and Lynn Amato, and Dana Walden, and Gary Newman for believing in this movie. We're only here because of one person, and that's Mr. Larry Kramer. We did this for him. Special thanks to our wonderful cast. Particularly a shout out to Julia Roberts and Mark Ruffalo, who got this movie made. After 30 years, it took the superpowers of Aaron Brockovich and the Incredible Hulk to finally get this thing alive. We're gonna use the rest of our time to ask young people watching to become Larry Kramers, to find a cause you believe in, that you will fight for, that you will die for. Go online. Look up AMFAR, look up the Elizabeth Glazer Pediatric AIDS Foundation. This is for all of the hundreds of thousands of artists who have passed from HIV/AIDS since 1981. Your memory and your passion burns on in us, and this is for them. Thank you.
And now let's all do our best Ricky Gervais impression by giving a huge round of applause for Ricky Gervais.
Hello. I lost again.
That was good. 21 times. 21 times I've been nominated. Lost 19. It's like a cruel joke. It's like they're going, oh, you're great. Am I? Yeah, come over. You're brilliant. Am I? No. No, you're not. You're not so good. Well done to Jim Parsons, though. I would have preferred to have won it, but, you know. Also, I've come a long way. He's probably local. It's just, isn't it? It's like 4 years in a row. It seems unfair, doesn't it? I wrote a speech. You're not going to get to hear that. So, well, actually, I can do it, couldn't I? I could do it. Yeah, yeah. It won't make sense now, though. Ha ha, I won. I knew I would because I am the best actor. See? Better than those other actors. Parsons, oh. Cheadle, H. Macy, Joey from Friends, and Louis from Louis, spelt slightly differently. Look at their stupid faces. Thank you to the Emmy voters who are never wrong. Well, we know that's bollocks now, so. When you are flown a long way, they let you do the big one, okay? This is outstanding writing for a variety special.
The Beatles, the night that changed America. Billy Crystal, 700 Sundays. The 71st Annual Golden Globe Awards. Sarah Silverman, We Are Miracles.
I like to start at
67th Annual Tony Awards. Show, chauffeuring cars. And the Emmy goes to Sarah Silverman, We Are Miracles.
This is the second Emmy win and sixth nomination for Sarah Silverman. She took home her first Emmy in the Outstanding Original Music and Lyrics category.
This didn't even occur to me. Thank you to my Jews at CAA, Larry Moe Curley, and Nick Mustaforo. Heidi Herzog produced it, and Liam Lynch directed it. We got the old team back together, HBO, Michael Lombardo, and Nina Rosenstein, and Ed Funny or Die, Betsy and Anna, and Amy's V, my friend and my manager and my partner, and thank you for being such a huge part of my life. Flanny, Mark Flanagan at Largo, thank you for making Largo my home and for introducing me to my love, Mr. Fancy Pants Sheen. And we're all just made of molecules and we're hurling through space right now. Thank you.
Year of change in late night television, and in a few moments we'll find out which of six nominated shows will take Emmy home tonight.
It was reported this week that male students in North Korea are being forced to have their hair cut just like Kim Jong-un, in other words, by a blind person.
Outstanding variety series next on NBC.
Please welcome two things that can happen to your car's paint job, Key and Peele.
Thank you, Emmy Academy. It is our honor to be here with you today to introduce the accountants.
You know what? I'm gonna call an audible here. We're seasoned improvisers. Let's turn off the prompter.
Okay. You want to wing it?
Yeah, let's
wing it. We're going to wing it. Good call.
And here we go. It is off.
All right.
And thank you.
Here we go.
Addition is the... Since
addition,
the invention
subtraction.
Of
okay, no, that's on you. Go, no, go ahead. That's
you. Got
that's
it. You got it.
That's you. Let's go.
You got it. The magic
can be fun.
Of accounting. Okay, this is...
Okay, no.
You said I got it.
No, you go ahead and do it, Dave.
No, you got
that's
it.
On you. That's on you. That's
you got
on
it.
You. That's on you.
You got it.
That's on you. Go ahead.
You got it. Okay.
That's on you. Go ahead,
all
do
right.
It.
Well,
that's on you.
Losing time. Losing time. Okay. Just, right. Okay.
You go. Go.
You go.
Go.
You go.
I'll go.
Blowing it at the Emmys.
Ridiculous.
This is it. Get it together.
Career's over.
All right, here it is.
Can you turn the top prompter back up,
please?
Ladies and gentlemen, the Emmy accountants from Ernst & Young, Andy Sale, Heidi Kajawa, and John Nendrick.
Is on track to become the first person to ever host the post-show talk show to his own talk show. Please welcome Chris Hardwick.
Guys, hello, hi everyone. Just want to talk for a quick sec about something very important, internet trolls. Probably getting trolled right now, that's fine, but I want to thank them. They provide a public service to everyone in this room because they dare to tell us the truth anonymously. How else would I know that I'm an unfunny douche if it weren't for @dongboobs420? But I have one important message for all the trolls out there, and I wanted to use the Emmy stage, this global stage, to get this message out. It's very important. I want them to listen. I don't know where the camera is. Okay, listen to me. This is very important, trolls. Please, understand what I'm about to tell you and write it down. Your, Y-O-U-R, is a possessive pronoun. Y-O-U apostrophe R-E is the contraction you are. As in, you're bad at your grammar. Thank you. #HardwickSmash. Now, let's give out a fancy award to a deserving human. The nominees for Outstanding Directing in a Variety Series are...
Greg Gelfand, The Beatles, The Night That Changed America. Hamish Hamilton, The Oscars. Louis J. Horvitz, The Kennedy Center Honors. James Lapine, Six by Sondheim. Beth McCarthy Miller, Rob Ashford, The Sound of Music Live. Glenn Weiss, 67th Annual Tony Awards.
There can be only one.
The Emmy goes to Glenn Weiss for the 67th Annual Tony Awards.
Thank you, yes. Thank you. This is beyond surreal, but also awesome, doing this while you're doing a show. The Tony Awards are such a passion project. I love doing them, but this represents a big, big, big team of people, like 700 people or so working from Broadway and television. I love and respect them all. No director is anything without his DGA, AD, and stage management team. I thank the AD and stage management team from the Tony Awards, from the Emmy Awards, from every other show we do, because you guys are awesome. I also thank everyone who's on headsets listening to all the fun stuff we do here. I want to thank my producing partner, Ricky Kirshner, the head writer, Dave Boone, and most importantly, for an insane open and an insane show, Mr. Neil Patrick Harris. You are awesome. The show was great. I thank you so much. Sydney Taylor, I wish you guys were here. Too bad you're not. Taylor, look, I wore it, and it brought me luck. Thank you. And Mom and Dad, I love you. Thank you very much. I appreciate this. We have to go back out and continue the show. Jan, thanks for being a part of this. And here we go. Standby announcer, cue announcer, take 8.
Please welcome Gwen Stefani and Adam Levine.
From the arrival of the royal baby to the departure of LeBron James from Miami.
From the legalization of marijuana to the illegal eavesdropping by the NSA, this year's variety series had plenty to talk about. Here are the nominees.
Yeah.
The Colbert Report. Real Time with Bill Maher. Daily Show with Jon Stewart. Saturday Night Live. Jimmy Kimmel Live, The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon.
And the Emmy goes to The Colbert Report.
The Colbert Report received 6 nominations this year. This is the 2nd consecutive win in this category for The Colbert Report. Accepting the Emmy on behalf of the team is Stephen Colbert.
unbelievable. She said it wrong, so there must be a mistake. So it's just very interesting. It's unbelievable. I'd love to see the envelope. I want to see the envelope because that. I just want to thank Stephen and all his writers for doing such a great job. I mean, you guys are the best. Colbert, you guys are the greatest. And we want to thank Comedy Central, of course. They're great. I want to thank his wife and his children. They're just fantastic. And everyone's worked on the show for the last 9 years. And you know who you are. If you don't know who you are, go to IMDb, and it's very comprehensive, so you could probably, if you always wanted to work on the show, and you don't have a chance now because it's ending, just put your name on IMDb and I'll back you up. Just call yourself like a creep, some bullshit like that. That's, don't make me say that. You're in trouble.
No, you said it.
No, you said it. Here.
Thank you. It has been a ton of fun to do the show for the last 9 years. Thank you so much for giving us this award. We want to thank Jon Stewart again. We want to thank everybody who's not on this stage, who worked on the show, who's back. Our writers won last week for writing a variety series. I'm so proud of those guys and one woman. And sorry for that for some reason. And I love my wife and I love my children. And thank you for all your patience with me. Thank you.
Hang out with Hollywood's finest. Go to NBC on Facebook for the Emmys experience. When the Emmy Awards continue, Halle Berry, Sofia Vergara, Julia Roberts, and supporting actor in a drama series.
I move that the executive committee immediately take the full partnership or proposal to relieve Alicia Florek of her duties.
When we return. Ladies and gentlemen, Sofia Vergara.
Buenas noches. I came to America with a big dream. And this dream, it was the same dream that so many young women of my generation had. To be one day on a stage just like this, introducing the CEO and chairman of the Television Academy. Please welcome Bruce Rosenbloom.
Thank you, Sophia. This has been a terrific year for American television, and our shows continue to have a meaningful impact around the world. So to demonstrate, we'd love for you to stand on this revolving platform.
That seems a bit unnecessary, but is that how they do it in American television? Okay. Wait, is it going to?
There you go. Okay. The Television Academy represents over 19,000 members from all creative professions involved in the magic of producing television, from acting and writing to sound editing and stunts. Our Academy is more diverse than ever before, both in front of and behind the camera, resulting and a greater diversity of storytelling. Thank you, thank you. Our Academy's charitable foundation has helped thousands of talented students refine their skills and forge rewarding careers throughout our industry. Our Academy is innovating and evolving to inspire our 21st century audience. Indeed, more people are watching more television on more devices and platforms than ever before. And our Academy never loses sight that no matter the device or platform, television has and will always be about great storytelling. To learn more about our Academy, our membership, and our activities, please join us at televisionacademy.com. What truly matters is that we never forget that our success is based on always giving the viewer something compelling to watch.
Busy.
She's played a Charlie's Angel and Sherlock's Watson, yet you keep telling your agents you have range. Please welcome Lucy Liu.
Thank you.
Good evening. The nominees for supporting actor in a drama series brought to life some of the year's favorite characters, inhabiting a wide range of worlds, from the polite drawing rooms of early 20th century England to the harrowing front lines of the war on terrorism. They are
Peter Dinklage, Game of Thrones.
I did not do it. I did not kill Joffrey, but I wish that I had. Watching your vicious bastard die gave me more relief than 1,000 lying whores.
Aaron Paul, Breaking Bad.
You had him still off of me, and all for that ass, Mr. White. He poisoned Brock, and you helped him.
Mandy Patinkin, Homeland.
It's justice.
It's ineffective. Because back in Tehran, he's replaced by someone just like him, who we can't control. And the attack that happened here happens again and again and again. This is once-in-a-lifetime operation that can transform everything.
Jim Carter, Downton Abbey.
I don't feel I could be helpful, no. And I would thank you not to remind me of a time in my life I prefer to forget.
John Voight, Ray Donovan.
I did 20 years for you. I took the rap for you and Ezra. And Sean, I kept my mouth shut. I did the time.
You did 20 years because you stole $500,000 from Sully.
I did the time for you, Ray.
Josh Charles, The Good Wife.
I hired you. I pushed for you.
Will, this is a business decision.
You were poison. This firm got you back on your feet.
And I will always be thankful.
And this is how you show it?
And the Emmy goes to Aaron Paul, Breaking Bad.
This is the third Emmy win and fifth nomination for Aaron Paul.
Oh, wow. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Can we please have another round of applause for Jim Carter, Josh Charles, Peter Dinklage, John Voight, and Mandy Patinkin? I know I can speak for everyone in this room. We are so happy that you found this gift inside of you guys and decided to share it with us, so thank you. Thank you so much. My God, Breaking Bad. It has changed my life, and I'm standing up here because of one man, and that is Vince Gilligan. Thank you so much, Vince. Thank you for believing in me, trusting in me to play this guy. I miss him, you know, I love him. The best cast and crew I've ever worked with and for. Brian, there's not a single day that goes by that I do not miss running to work, to be able to work opposite of you, my friend. I've learned so much on screen and off. Thank you, thank you. Cass, I love you guys. My friends, my family, thank you. And to my wife, my God. Thank you for marrying me. Thank you for dedicating your life to spread kindness across the world. We all appreciate it. If you guys don't know what she does, look up Kind Campaign. Do yourself and your children a favor. Kind Campaign. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Clouds in the sky.
If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you.
Whatever that means.
It's Saturday Night Live!
When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile.
Just try and separate what happens here from the fun part of my life.
Do you realize what talking movies will mean for you?
At last!
I breastfed you for 9 years.
He had to come by here. He had a cowboy hat, you know, 10-gallon hat, jeans, boots, all that.
That's the time.
I am grateful to have been loved.
Smile, what's the use in crying? You'll see that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
He made us laugh hard every time you saw him on television, movies, nightclubs, arenas, hospitals, homeless shelters for our troops overseas, and even in a dying girl's living room for her last wish. He made us laugh big time. I spent many happy hours with Robin on stage. I mean, the brilliance was astounding. The relentless energy was kind of thrilling. I used to think if I could just put a saddle on him and stay on for 8 seconds, I was going to do okay. Robin, Whoopi, and I once were in Shea Stadium in the broadcast booth with the great Tim McCarver. It was Comic Relief Day for the New York Mets, and Robin knew nothing about baseball. I asked him, "What's your favorite team?" And he said, "The San Franciscos." So he was a little lost in the conversation, so I got an idea, and I said, "You know, Tim, we have a great Russian baseball player with us." And I looked over, his eyes got all bright, his ears perked up. It was like he was a little dog that was inside all day, and the master came and said, "Hey, you want to go for a walk?" So I said, what's baseball like in Russia? Without missing a beat, he said, well, we only have one team, the Reds. Well, the next pitch, the batter fouled one off. It came screaming back at us. We ducked down. It slammed against the wall. Robin turned around. It bounced into his hands, and he stood up and screamed, I love America. I'm going to defect. He could be funny anywhere. We were such close friends. He would come to all of our great family functions, weddings, bar mitzvahs, that kind of thing. And he would sit with my older immigrant relatives like he was one of the guys. And he would tell them about his journey from his little shtetl in Poland to America. One uncle of mine said, I came to America after World War II and I hitchhiked. And Robin said, I waited till there was a 747 and a kosher meal. Well, as genius as he was on stage, he was the greatest friend you could ever imagine. Supportive, protective, loving. It's very hard to talk about him in the past because he was so present in all of our lives. For almost 40 years, he was the brightest star in a comedy galaxy. But while some of the brightest of our celestial bodies are actually extinct now, their energy long since cooled, but miraculously, because they float in the heavens so far away from us now, their beautiful light will continue to shine on us forever. And the glow will be so bright, it'll warm your heart, it'll make your eyes glisten, and you'll think to yourselves, Robin Williams, what a concept.
And yet look, vile fool, come thee hither.
No!
Thou hast forced me to wear designer jeans for no reason. I will walk now, and cameramen shall be going, where's he going now? Where am I now?
Let me borrow your little shawl. We've never met before, have we?
I came to Bombay last year.
I would like to welcome you to Iran. Help me!
God gives, you know, it gives you a penis and a brain, and only enough blood to run one at a time.
There are times my son looks at me, gives me that look in the eyes like,
well, what's it gonna be?
I don't know. But maybe along the way, he'd take my hand, tell a few jokes, and have some fun. Come on, pal. You're not afraid, are you?
Nah.
Our next presenters, Deborah Messing and Jim Parsons, are known by viewers for their roles in some of the greatest sitcoms of all time, and known by David Caruso as a couple of Messing Parsons. Please welcome Deborah Messing and Jim Parsons.
Here are the nominees for Outstanding Directing in a Drama Series.
Tim Van Patten, Boardwalk Empire, Farewell Daddy Blues. Vince Gilligan, Breaking Bad, Felina. David Evans, Downton Abbey, Episode 1. Neil Marshall, Game of Thrones, The Watchers on the Wall. Carl Franklin, House of Cards, Chapter 14. Kerry Joji Fukunaga, True Detective, Who Goes There?
And the Emmy goes to...
Kerry Joji Fukunaga.
True Detective.
This is the first Emmy win and second nomination tonight for director, writer, cinematographer, Kerry Joji Fukunaga, who's also nominated as part of the producing team of True Detective. His first job in L.A. was working as a camera PA on the music video for Destiny Child's Survivor.
Oh, man. I should have written something. This is awesome. You're gonna need a broom to sweep up what the name is about to drop. Thank you to HBO, Lombardo, Ellenberg, Levine. Thank you to the Television Academy. Thank you to Golan, Michael Sugar, Ed Anonymous, WME, Craig Castell, the whole crew during production and post. Of course, to my family and to my friends back home watching New York. What's up? This is awesome. I'm at a loss for words. Thank you.
Here are the nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama Series.
Lena Headey, Game of Thrones. Joanne Froggatt, Downton Abbey. Christine Baranski, The Good Wife. Christina Hendricks, Mad Men. Maggie Smith, Downton Abbey. Anna Gunn, Breaking Bad.
And the Emmy goes to... Can you
say? Anna Gunn.
For her portrayal of Skyler White on Breaking Bad, this is the second consecutive Emmy win and third consecutive nomination for Anna Gunn.
Thank you so much to the Academy, and I am just so honored to be in the company of my fellow nominees, and I am inspired by all of your work. It is luck that brought me 7 years ago to getting a phone call from Sharon Bialy, our amazing casting director, who said, get your patootie in here and read for this show. It's the best thing that you, it's the best pilot script I've ever seen. And she was right, and it turned into the most extraordinary journey over the past 7 years, and I have been unbelievably fortunate. And Vince Gilligan, you're the reason for that, so thank you. Our amazing producers, our incredible writers, our amazing crew back in New Mexico, and also the most remarkable cast that I could ever have asked to work with every single day, especially Bryan Cranston, my TV husband, the baddest and the absolute best human being and the best scene partner I could have ever asked for. I love you. And Mom and Dad, you're my heart, and thank you for keeping me going all these years and never letting me give up. Thank you very much.
Please welcome Emmy winner Katherine Heigl.
On Saturday, August 16th, Emmys were awarded for Outstanding Guest Actor and Guest Actress in a Drama Series. The nominees were
Dylan Baker, The Good Wife. Beau Bridges, Masters of Sex. Reggie Cathy, House of Cards. Paul Giamatti, Downton Abbey. Robert Morse, Mad Men. Joe Morton, Scandal. Kate Burton, Scandal. Jane Fonda, The Newsroom. Allison Janney, Masters of Sex. Kate Mara, House of Cards. Margot Martindale, The Americans. Diana Rigg, Game of Thrones.
And the winners were Allison Janney and Joe Morton, who is here tonight to present the next award.
As an actor lucky enough to have been given beautiful monologues to deliver, I'm honored to present the award for Outstanding Writer for a Drama Series. The nominees are...
Breaking Bad, Felina, written by Vince Gilligan. Breaking Bad, Ozymandias, written by Maura Wally Beckett. Game of Thrones, The Children, written by David Benioff and D.B. Weiss. House of Cards, Chapter 14, written by Beau Willimon. True Detective, The Secret Fate of All Life, written by Nick Pizzolatto.
And the Emmy goes to Maura Wally Beckett, Breaking Bad.
This is the second Emmy win and third nomination for Maura Wally Beckett. She took home her first trophy last year for being part of the producing team of Breaking Bad.
Vince Gilligan, this is your fault. Thank you for your mentorship and your mad skills, yo. I share this wholeheartedly with you and with my fellow writers, Sam Catlin, Tom Schnoz, Peter Gould, George Masters, and Jenny Hutchinson. I couldn't have asked for better fellow comrades all those years in that seedy foxhole in Burbank. To my brilliant cast of actors, writing for you was pure joy. To my wonder twin, director Rian Johnson, you realized Ozymandias beautifully. To Melissa Bernstein, thank you for taking a chance and bringing me to Vince. To my agent, Josh Hornstock, for your unwavering support. To AMC and Sony for being so damn cool, and to the Academy, it's not possible for me to be more thrilled by this gleaming honor. Thank you.
Please welcome Viola Davis.
The following nominees play women who struggle to overcome extraordinary challenges, and in doing so, learn something about themselves. The nominees for lead actress in a drama series are Lizzie Kaplan, Masters of Sex, Claire Danes, Homeland, Michelle Dockery, Downton Abbey, Juliana Margulies, The Good Wife, Kerry Washington, Scandal, Robin Wright, House of Cards. And the Emmy goes to Juliana Margulies for The Good Wife.
This is the third Emmy win and 10th nomination for Juliana Margulies. Her first win was for her supporting actress performance on ER.
Thank you so much. What a wonderful time for women on television. And all the women that I'm nominated with here tonight is such a testament to that. But truly, this belongs to Robert and Michelle King. All our writers, who never cease to amaze me with 22 episodes a year. And I have to thank my gorgeous cast. You are spectacular. Christine Baranski, you are a beacon of light to all of us. And Josh Charles, I miss you every day. What were you thinking? And to my amazing crew, my sweet Nellies, my Joe, Alex Noncalli and Kerry Ross for keeping me alive. And I just want to say a big thank you to Jim McKay, who directed the episode that I submitted with such clarity, and to the two best things that ever happened to me, Keith and Kieran. Best part of my day is coming home to you. I love you. Thank you.
Coming up next, Matthew McConaughey could make history as the first actor ever to win the Lead Actor Oscar and the Emmy for Lead Actor in a Drama in the same year.
We'd like to take a moment to acknowledge Sarah Bareilles' performance of Smile during this year's In Memoriam. Let's give it up for Sarah. And now, please welcome a woman who starred in Mystic Pizza 25 years ago and then was never heard from again, Julia Roberts.
Manipulative, insecure, scary, and obsessive. Often good-looking, but full of dark secrets. That's not just how we describe the average actor, but also the characters portrayed by these six great performers. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Actor in a Drama Series. Bryan Cranston, Breaking Bad. I feel like I have to get serious. Jeff Daniels, The Newsroom. John Hamm, Mad Men. Woody Harrelson, True Detective. All right. Matthew McConaughey, True Detective. Kevin Spacey, House of Cards. Okay, this is horrible. This is a horrible category. God, I'm glad I'm not in this category. And I apologize to anybody who doesn't hug me in the next 10 seconds. The Emmy goes to, and you're all fabulous, by the way. And the Emmy goes to Bryan Cranston. Breaking Bad.
This is the fifth Emmy win and 12th nomination for Bryan Cranston. He now has four trophies for his portrayal of Walter White on Breaking Bad, and one for being one of the producers on the show.
Even I thought about voting for Matthew. My friend, I don't know why I have been blessed with an abundance of good fortune in my life. I was a kid who always looked for the shortcut, schemer. My own family nicknamed me Sneaky Pete. My own family. So, I did happen to stumble upon finding a passion that created a seed and bloomed into something so wonderful for me. I love to act. It is a passion of mine, and I will do it until my last breath. I can only say that I have gratitude for everything that has happened. I have gratitude for the Academy for this lovely honor. To the love of my family, I love you guys. To gratitude for AMC and Sony, and especially Vince Gilligan, to make this possible for me to have this role of a lifetime. Gratitude for our writers, our directors, the wonderful crew that we have in New Mexico, and this intimate cast that we created. My dear friend Aaron Paul, I love you so much. You were with me all the way, and I appreciate that, and helping each other. To Anna Gunn, my television wife extraordinaire, I love you, and especially those scenes in bed. Finally, I want to just say that I'd like to dedicate this award to all the Sneaky Petes of the world who thought that maybe settling for mediocrity was a good idea because it was safe. Don't do it. Take a chance. Take a risk. Find that passion. Rekindle it. Fall in love all over again. It's really worth it. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce Jay Leno.
Thank you. It is hard to believe we're almost a tenth of the way through the evening. The nominees for Outstanding Comedy Series are...
The Big Bang Theory. Louie. Modern Family. Orange is the New Black. Silicon Valley. Veep.
And the winner is... Modern Family!
Modern Family received 10 nominations this year and has a total of 67 nominations since its premiere. This is the fifth consecutive Emmy win in the comedy series category. Accepting the Emmy on behalf of the team is Steven Levitan.
Thank you so much. When my daughter was 10, she came to work with me on a day that we were trying to come up with a story. She sat with a room full of writers, watching them think, talk, share anecdotes, watch YouTube videos, anything to spark an idea. And 8 long hours later, we had absolutely nothing. We went home and I was a little bit embarrassed. And then she looked up at me and these big eyes, and she said, "Thanks for taking me to work with you, Daddy. I really loved it so much. I learned what you did, and it makes me so proud." And then she turned into the kitchen and said to my wife, "It's a wonder we have a roof over our heads." It's all a wonder that we get to do this for a living, that we get to be the ones up here when there are so many deserving shows, that we get to touch so many people's lives, and that we get to work with such extraordinary people like this every single day. I don't know how else to say it, but Modern Family has been a big, beautiful dream for the last 5 years, and we thank you for not waking us up. Thank you.
Coming up, Halle Berry presents the award for Outstanding Drama Series when the Emmy Awards continue on NBC.
Our next presenter has won an Emmy, an Academy Award, and the Genetics Lottery. Please help me welcome Halle Berry.
The nominees for Outstanding Drama Series are... Breaking Bad. Downton Abbey. Game of Thrones. House of Cards. Mad Men. True Detective. And the Emmy goes to Breaking Bad.
This year, Breaking Bad received 16 Emmy nominations and has a total of 58 to date. Accepting the second consecutive Emmy for drama series on behalf of the team is Vince Gilligan.
Thank you.
Holy cow. Fastest Emmys ever. Man, this thing flew. Thank you so much for this this wonderful farewell to our show. You have been very kind to us indeed. And congratulations to all the other nominees who we are honored to stand amongst. This is indeed a wonderful time to be working in television. I think you all know that. We're lucky all to be working now. And I want to thank AMC and Sony, and I want to thank the best damn crew ever in Albuquerque, New Mexico. I want to thank my wonderful producers and the best cast, the best writers and directors. Colin Buxey, who won tonight, Adam Bernstein, you're over there too. Congratulations to you guys and Michelle McLaren, all our other directors, and of course, Mr. Bryan Cranston and Aaron Paul, Anna Gunn, Dean Norris, who couldn't be here tonight, RJ Mitty, Betsy Brandt. Thank you very much.
Thank you and good night, everybody. Have a wonderful evening. Only 4 days till the weekend.
Nominations are